Hello everyone, welcome back to Active Learning. This video is a result of thinking about the absolutely incredible 3 blue 1 brown video on the Basel problem and an attempt to generalize it in different directions. Grant himself made another video, this time using the idea of lighthouses to prove the Wallis formula. Our aim by the end of the video is to be able to use this idea to solve Basel-like problems and even their linear counterparts. Grant's video starts with an observer at the bottom of a circular lake and a lighthouse at its topmost point. But what if we place the lighthouse at a different point on the circle? I mean, the argument that we are about to see works well for any point on the circle. But for the sake of clarity, let's place the lighthouse at this point, where it makes an angle of pi by 5 at the top of the circle. For reasons that will be clear in a moment or so, we choose the diameter of the lake to be 5 by pi so that its circumference becomes 5 units. The brightness perceived by the observer is 1 divided by the square of the distance between the observer and the lighthouse. We now complete this right angle triangle, which shows that the distance between the observer and the lighthouse is 5 by pi times the sine of pi by 5. The apparent brightness to the observer is then 1 divided by 5 by pi times sine of pi by 5 the whole squared. The angle subtended by the observer and the lighthouse at the center of the circle is 2 pi by 5 by the inscribed angle theorem. The distance between the observer and the lighthouse along the circle is then this angle times the radius of the circle. That works out to be exactly 1 unit. Just to recap a little, the central idea on the original video was the inverse Pythagorean theorem, which shows how we can replace a single lighthouse anywhere on the plane with 2 lighthouses on the coordinate axis. We use the same idea here and proceed with our initial lighthouse. Like in Grant's video, we can now draw a bigger circle, twice as big as the previous one, and draw a line from that lighthouse through the top of the smaller circle. Now we get 2 points where the line intersects the larger circle. Since this line is a diameter of the larger circle, lines from these new points to the observer form a right angle. The inverse Pythagorean theorem applies, and we can replace our initial lighthouse with 2 new lighthouses on the bigger circle without changing the apparent brightness to the observer. The radius of the bigger circle, which is the diameter of the smaller circle, is 5 by pi. The angle between the observer and the lighthouse nearest to them is pi by 5. The distance between them along the bigger circle is then the radius of the bigger circle times the angle at the center. Therefore, the lighthouse is still at a distance of 1 unit from the observer along the circle. The circumference of the bigger circle is now 10 units, and the 2 new lighthouses divide it equally. That means the lighthouses are at a distance of 5 units from each other along the circle. We can now repeat this process again, keeping an eye on 3 interesting facts. First, the distance between the observer and the lighthouse nearest to them along the circle will always be 1 unit, because in every step of the transformation, we double the radius of the circle and halve the angle between the observer and the lighthouse. Second, the distance between the lighthouses will always be 5 units, because again, in each iteration, we double both the circumference of the circle and the number of lighthouses. Third, because the inverse Pythagorean theorem applies all the way, the apparent brightness to the observer remains unchanged. Repeating this process ad infinitum, we see that the first lighthouse lands at the point 1,0 on the number line, and all the lighthouses are at a distance of 5 units from the ones before them. Because the combined brightness of all these lighthouses equal the brightness of our initial lighthouse, adding up all these numbers is going to give us the brightness level we started with. That's it. Instead of having all the integers in the Basel problem, we now have a way of calculating the sum of inverse squares of numbers that leave a remainder of plus or minus 1 when divided by 5. To make it more general, we can rephrase this equation and collect all the terms where the number 5 shows up. That should give a hint of what we should be getting if we place our initial lighthouse at an arbitrary angle. Using this, I am going to claim that pi square by sine square pi x equals the sum of 1 by x plus k the whole square, where k runs over all integers. We now have a very general result about the Basel problem, but most of what we have done slightly generalized the argument. To make something even more amazing out of this, we introduced a new type of lighthouse. Think of an observer at the origin of the xy plane with a lighthouse at the point r,0. What's weird about these bizarre blue lighthouses is that the apparent brightness to the observer due to this lighthouse is inversely proportional to the signed distance between them, not the inverse of the squared distance like the ones we expect. As a consequence of this, if the lighthouse is to the left of the observer, it casts a sort of negative brightness on the observer. With that in mind, we now need a way to replace a single lighthouse of this bizarre kind by two lighthouses of the similar kind without changing the apparent brightness to the observer. Imagine two lighthouses on the number line. Choose a point, any point on the y-axis, and draw lines connecting the lighthouses to this point. Now draw perpendiculars to the blue lines from the origin. We now extend the line joining the yellow points till it meets the x-axis and place a new lighthouse there. The position of this new lighthouse is independent of the dot on the y-axis, which is a very useful fact for our problem. If the new lighthouse is at a distance little c from the origin, and the lighthouses we started with are at distances little a and little b from the origin, then it so happens that 1 by c equals 1 by a plus 1 by b. In the context of brightness from these lighthouses, this relation means that the brightness from the new lighthouse to the observer is the sum of the brightness of the two lighthouses we started with. This relation is true even if the lighthouses are at the other side of the origin. We only have to remember to use the signed distances for A, B and C. For a lack of a better name, we call this the inverse sum theorem. But why is that, you might ask? It's not hard, just a couple of geometric and trigonometric ideas that intertwine neatly to give this beautiful result. I don't want to digress from the main topic here. I have three proofs of this result, which I give in a blog post linked in the video description. But I would definitely encourage those interested to pause the video here and give a shot at the proof of this idea. We now have a way of replacing two lighthouses by a single lighthouse placed at the right point. But it would be nice to go in the other direction. In fact, that is actually what we want. Replace a single lighthouse by two lighthouses without changing the apparent brightness. It may not be immediately clear how to do that, especially with the procedure we have used to combine two lighthouses, until we draw this circle here. To transform a single lighthouse into two, draw a line through the lighthouse such that it intersects the circle at two points. Now draw a line from the top of the circle to each of the yellow points, which from now on we'll call the indicator points, till they meet the x-axis, and place a new lighthouse at these points. The inverse sum theorem applies now and ensures that the apparent brightness to the observer remains unchanged between the initial lighthouse and the two new ones we have created. We get back to the circular lake now. Though the argument works for any point on the lake, we again choose this point, which makes an angle of pi by pi at the top of the circle, and choose the diameter of the circle to be pi by pi, so that the circumference of the circle becomes 5 units. Now we don't place our lighthouse here. This will be our first indicator point. We extend the line from the top of the circle to the indicator point till it meets the x-axis and place the lighthouse at this new point. This will be our first lighthouse. We now draw a circle twice as big. To transform our initial lighthouse, We draw a line from the lighthouse to the center of the bigger circle and consider the two points of intersection. These indicator points will then show us where the new lighthouses should go. Draw lines from the top of the bigger circle to the indicator points and extend them to reach the x-axis. We know that replacing the single lighthouse we started with two new lighthouses at this point keeps the apparent brightness unchanged to the observer because of the inverse sum theorem. At the risk of repeating things, the first indicator point will be at a distance of 1 unit from the observer along the circle, and the two new indicator points will be at a distance of 5 units from each other along the circle. We can now repeat the transformation again. Draw a bigger circle twice as big. For each of the lighthouses, draw a line connecting the lighthouse to the center of the bigger circle, getting a new pair of intersection points. Draw lines from the top of the bigger circle through the indicator points to get the locations of the new lighthouses in the x-axis. The final piece of this puzzle is the fact that the indicator points coincides with points on the number line as the circle gets infinitely bigger. That means the new lighthouses themselves will be located at those points. At this stage, the first lighthouse will be at a distance of 1 unit from the origin, while the other lighthouses will be at a distance of 5 units from the ones before them. The total apparent brightness of all these lighthouses is then the sum of 1, minus 1 by 4, plus 1 by 6, minus 1 by 9, and so on. But what about the brightness of our initial lighthouse? We know that the diameter of the circle we started with is 5 by pi, and the angle at the top of the circle is pi by 5. And that gives the distance between the observer and the lighthouse to be 5 by pi times tan pi by 5. The brightness in this case is then 1 divided by 5 by pi times tan pi by 5, which must be equal to the infinite series. Again, we can slightly rearrange the equation that will point us to a possible generalization. With this, we can claim that pi by tan pi x equals the sum of 1 by x plus k, where k runs through all integers. For example, using x is equal to 1 by 4 gives the well-known Madhava's series for pi. Now that we have this series representation of pi by tan x, we can differentiate this expression with respect to x and get the inverse sum of squares result that we saw in the first half of the video. In fact, we can continue to differentiate the resulting expression and get a very general equation for the inverse sum of mth powers. On the other direction, we can integrate the series representation of pi by tan pi x, which gives us the famous product series for sine pi x. Hope you enjoyed the discussion. Thanks for joining me, and see you in the next video.